I'm George Edelman with StudioBinder, and today we are going to talk about the production calendar. So what we're going to talk about in this video series is all the things you can do with your production calendar to make your shoot smoother. Not only that, we're going to talk about how this calendar can double as a great presentation tool. Right now, we're going to focus on the basics. How do you create a calendar? How do you create an event? So we'll go up here to this production calendar dropdown. You'll just click on Add Calendar and you'll see this modal pop up. For now, we're just going to call it Short Film. Then we'll click Next. Now you have an option here to use a template. Some templates will be there for you already. Over time, and we'll go over this in a later video, you'll be able to create templates on your own. But for now, let's just go with the blank calendar. And here we are. So the next thing we're going to go over is how to create an event. All you have to do to create an event is click. Let's call it Hire Director. And here we can enter in a date range, so we can customize how long we want this to be, maybe 3 days. I always like to give myself longer just in case. So I'm going to go ahead and give us through the weekend. And now we can also add tasks. So with the ability to add tasks, you can do something like review applicants, and later someone will be able to click off this task if it's done, just like that. If you want to remove the task, that's an option. If you want to add a new task, that's also an option. You can attach files here. Say there's an applicant resume you want to attach, that's an option. And we can add comments. Now here's another really cool thing you can do. Up here, you have the option of changing the color of this event. So let's say we're going to make all our hiring events red. Click off, and there it is. Our first event created on our calendar in this row right here. And now we create a new event in the same row. See how easy that is. Something I really like to do is always consistently color my departments. So say my art department is always going to be red. Not only will everyone who works for me know that everything red on the calendar is for the art department, but so will I. So it'll be a lot easier for me to look at the calendar and immediately know right there, that's what they need to do. That's their time frame. This is one of the great things about using the colors. Now here's another cool thing we can do. We'll go over here and we're gonna add a row. And say we'll call this row casting. We can give this a color too. So now casting is gonna be yellow. And now unlike here, where we created the event and then we added the color, with casting, every time we create a new event, it's automatically yellow. So there's auditions, and then maybe in the following week, we'll create another event. And then the next. So there you can easily see how I use the row and the color of the row to create all the events within that department. There's also the other option we showed you, which is you can just create the event on the calendar and color it yourself there, however you want to do it. Another cool thing you can do is you can duplicate an event, or you can click on it and rename it, make comments, add tasks. And right here, you see I have the option to assign users. So I can always go through here and assign a user. One of the really cool things about this calendar is it's so customizable. Whatever works for you works for this calendar. So it's that easy to start creating events in your new calendar. Next time, we're going to talk about what you do when it's time to make changes and revisions to the events you already have in there. Until then, thanks so much for watching. Hope you found this helpful. Let us know what you think. And check back soon for more videos like this and other pro tip videos.